Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, and so much for a death montage, I got it in the next try. So yeah, those are the Pontiff piece. That's a bonfire, this is a secret area, and that's a dude? I don't know, but I got a ring. I am intrigued. Also, the Pontiff Beast fight is so much more enjoyable when it's in a more open area like this. It's actually pretty cool. The bridge was a bit annoying, but this area, I don't mind fighting Pontiff Beast here. That was kind of neat. It's also a good place to use my Wolf Knight Greatsword. They seem to die well to that. So who are you? Well, I don't know. Get your covenant symbol. Aldrich Faithful! Okay, so that's how you get it. Proof of the covenant. Okay, and yeah, human dregs. Dregs. I mean, I know there was blood dregs in... Was it Bloodborne? I think they had blood dregs. I'm having a hard time remembering what dregs came from. I mean, blood dregs were in Bloodborne. It was part of the Vampire Covenant. What were they called? I don't know, whichever one was the Cainhurst one. That was blood dregs that you got from killing enemies. Invader. Well, you certainly knew what to do. Your parents named you well. Or, obviously, being that this is a game, you named yourself well. Anyway, switch. Actually, let's stick with this. This is actually kind of poise breaking. What's gonna look at, though? I'll wait until he gets here. Do some story time. Story time under pressure. All right. Ring of Favor. A ring symbolizing the favor of the goddess Fina, whose fateful beauty is mentioned in legend. True to the fickle nature of things. Fina's favor, her ring increases magic, HP, stamina, and equip load. And yes, I kind of memorized that because, well, let's put it this way. This isn't the first time that rings come up. Like so much else in these games, it is not the first time. Like this guy, for instance, this invader, mind you, human invader, is referencing, what was her name? Well, at least I used that bonfire. I can't remember the name. It was... I don't know. It'll come to me. It was one of the CPU control invaders. I can't remember their name offhand. But yeah, that was... I guess who that was. And also... Okay, so there's a couple things I needed to go over. So yeah, the Ring of Favor, which, if I'm not mistaken, yeah, maximum equip load. So my guess is you put it on, you get all these things increased, you take it off, it breaks, and you don't get it until the next run. That's usually how these things go. And it's not as powerful as Havel's Ring, so yeah. But that's usually the way it goes, and frankly, it's... Nowhere near as powerful as it... Actually, no, it's about as powerful as it was in Dark Souls 1 in terms of relative power, but absolute power, no. Anyway, Aldrich Faithful. The holy symbol of the Cathedral of the Deep, and crest of those who see beyond fire to the Age of Deep Waters. Equipped to pledge oneself to the Aldrich Faithful Covenant. The faithful ensure that Aldrich, devourer of gods, remains undisturbed by taking the form of loyal spirits and hunting down those who would trespass the ruined cathedral. Summoning takes place automatically while this is equipped. So basically, it's another Darkroot, or Forest Hunters rather, Covenant, just in this area of the game, rather than in general. Okay. Oh, right, I got 42k souls. I might. I'll. Hang on a sec, I'll be back in a sec to level up. Alright, so I wonder, I noticed that the Aldrich thing is mentioning Age of Deep Waters. That's a new thing. That's a new thing for Dark Souls from a lore perspective. It's always been Age of Fire, Age of Dark, never Age of Water. I mean, that kind of makes sense, in a way. Granted, I mean, according to the fire versus water thing has never really come up, so I guess that kind of makes sense. But overall, that's still kind of new. That's not something I've really encountered before. Also, I did upgrade the Irithyll Straight Sword a bit, and it's at this point, very slightly more powerful than the longsword for now, until the longsword gets upgraded again, which will happen the moment I get a Titanite chunk. Oh, I don't know, actually, come to think of it. What's my current upgrade status? Okay, yeah, probably the moment I get a Titanite chunk, because the light crossbow, well, could definitely use it, Actually, I don't know. I'll think about it. It's like one titanite chunk would be enough for the longsword, but three would be enough for the crossbow, and the crossbow needs a lot more. Because the longsword scales, the crossbow doesn't. What do you have to say? Projectile? Oh, right, yeah, the archer. Oh, you've gotta be kidding me. Again? I mean, it's easier than last time, but again? Okay, for the uninitiated, Google Anor Londo archers. Just Google it. I don't have my Dark Souls playthrough right now at the point where I could just cut to footage of it, but seriously, just Google it. Honestly, it is a meme. Ooh, Titanite scale, nice. I need another 7 of those to upgrade this longsword. Or not the longsword, the Wolf Knight greatsword. But hey, that's cool. Anyway, yeah, so Anor Londo archers, Mark II. I didn't bring any poison arrows. Ow! Alright. Let's approach this a bit more cautiously. So, it looks like, unlike the original form of the Anor Londo archers, there's an alternate path. Like, originally you just had this one narrow path with some fencing that made it a bit harder for you to get hit at the very start. But now you're given an alternate path that you can, to some extent, use that'll allow you to very rapidly deal with these archers. Ow! Not helping the fact that they're, well, notwithstanding the fact that they're also perfectly powerful melee combatants. Am I dead? Not yet. You might be, though. No, you're not. Wait, did it just move? All right, one of them down. Another large titanite shard. Could use that. Sort of. Not usually. But I have another crossbow I'm considering using at some point. Oh, please fall. How many archers are there? Well, that was a Pyrrhic victory. But yeah, how many archers are there? I expected 2. Apparently there's more than that. Okay, good to know. That'd have been a good time to kick. Anyway. Try that again. Why not? I've been boosting faith. Maybe I should get lightning spearing going. It's something I haven't really done much of recently. I mean, I have Lightning Spear. I have had Lightning Spear for a long time. And I am holding out for Great Lightning Spear to an extent, too. But that's probably also 30 faith, so hey, I'll just get that. And if it requires sunlight medals, well, I've got 28 of them, so I'm good. I've been doing co-op a lot. I just like doing co-op. I mean, that's why I'm doing Warrior Sunlight, because I like doing co-op. It's fun. I like helping people. I'm just that kind of guy. Or, well, the character's just that kind of woman. Okay. How many large titanite shards do I have, anyway? Just 4. I think I could upgrade. No, there's something else I wanted to upgrade, I think. Oh, right, the claymore. I was still trying to figure out. Oh, that's where you are. Ow. Ow. That was embarrassing. Well, this may be another montage. I feel like my initial approach was a better option. I may do that again. Oh, okay, these are Silver Knights. Also, I'm gonna start talking again. There's more of them anyway. Wait, these aren't the Black Knights. Oh, wait, no, right, Black Knights are very specific. Silver Knights are more the Anor Londo thing. So yeah, we are in Anor Londo Mark II. That's become very clear, abundantly so. In fact. Ow! Ah, shoot, I gotta... Is it not running? Sure was running. Stun! Ow, we trade. But I win trades! Aha! And that is why I'm better. Oh, this looks a little bit like... Oh, bloody hell. Why can't I remember names? These names in these series is hard to remember. It's the place you start out in Bloodborne. I can't remember what it's called. Or the person's name. But yeah, it's almost what it reminds me of, except you can't get into it in any way. So, another one of these Silver Knights down here, and they have an archer. Ow! Oh, shoot. Wrong type of Estus. Ugh. Alright. Well, you're backstabbed. Good. Done. Manageable enough. There's at least tactical terrain I can work with here. It's not all terrible. Oh! I thought I was wielding my crossbow. I'm so used to having my crossbow on that I forgot that I didn't for a sec. Now I can heal. Alright. So now my Titanite Shard count, 15 regular, 4 large. No real development in the large front. Dang. Oh well. So, is this a path to the shortcut? Because I know there was a shortcut. Praise the bonfire? Yes, there is, okay. Is this Visions of Trap, but no princess ahead? I don't know if I want to do this after having to, well, okay, you know what? I could probably run past those Silver Knights pretty easily. Only one of them I think was really causing a huge amount of trouble, the one that was actually fighting directly. Well, spinning staircase. Yep, spinning staircase. We are back in Anor Londo. I mean, as if that wasn't already clear. Although, does that mean that that's the Dark Moon? Oh! I know where we are. I know exactly where we are. I should have actually picked up on it when it came to the tomb. This is where you'd... If you were playing Dark Souls 1, there's actually a ring. I can't remember what it's called. It's not the Ring of the Sun's Firstborn. It's the Seance Ring? I can't remember which ring it was. There was a ring that you got that opened this area up, or you just, if you killed, well, dispelled the illusion of Princess Guinevere, the woman in the painting I showed a couple episodes ago, then you would actually get this area open. And then, if you did it with a ring, you could join the Blades of the Dark Moon Covenant, which was the covenant I mentioned a while ago. That's effectively, I think I actually have the covenant item for it. No, I don't. But it's basically, people get invaded, and then after they get invaded, they indict the people who invade them, and then the Blades of the Dark Moon come in and get revenge. Now, that's a covenant that was in Dark Souls 1. And this is the equivalent area where you got in Dark Souls 1, effectively. Is this whole setup. The lowest area was the Dark Moon Tomb. However, the rest of this area does not look totally like it. But yeah, my guess is you go in there and you fight Dark Sun Gwendolyn again, I guess? I mean, that makes sense to me, but that also seems a little, especially given the message. So that's my guess, is that you basically have to fight Gwendolyn all over again. But let's go up, and where gargoyles would be in Dark Souls 1. It just feels weird to talk about that now after Global Reset Day happened, and I basically didn't... Well, I haven't jumped back to Global Reset Day. Anor Londo! Oh, it's not even old Anor Londo. It's straight up Anor Londo. Irithyll's just below Anor Londo. Hey! My wish has been granted then! I actually really wanted... Okay, so... Shoot, I kind of wish I had a save file that allowed me to just teleport to Anor Londo, but unfortunately my... I didn't even think about this. Because my save's all the way back in Unparish, and I don't really feel like playing through it suddenly. But, despite Global Reset Day and all that... Basically, everyone's starting new characters. I haven't done it yet. Seems like a cool idea, though. Starting new characters, using the PvP stuff, basically acting as if Dark Souls 1 was just released. Cool idea. Dark Souls 1's a great game. So I'm really glad that that's getting the attention it deserves. I mean, Dark Souls 3's good, don't get me wrong. It's just... It's always nice when people put in an effort to make games that aren't necessarily the most popular or the latest and greatest or whatever, but are still good, get the attention they deserve. But independent of that, one thing that always annoyed me about Anor Londo was where we are now in the Darkmoon Tomb area, and there are some other areas that you don't see because they're no longer here. They're ruined to the point of being gone. They're in the original game, there's a path leading this way, all the way up another staircase that I guess goes up to there? Like that area in the distance, I guess? That doesn't really look like the Duke's Archives. Although, admittedly, you go down here, there's this big path, you follow up here, and then over there would be a bonfire where the Firekeeper was, and then to the right, not so much there, but to the right, there's a path that led kind of over there to the Duke's Archives, but the Duke's Archives aren't really there. So, yeah, a lot has changed there, but yes, that's where the staircase would lead. This other side, though, that's pretty much old school Anor Londo. One thing I didn't like about Anor Londo in Dark Souls 1, though, is that was it. The Blaze of the Dark Moon Tomb, that was the lowest you could go. But there was this whole city you saw, this whole skybox of things you could see but you couldn't get to. And I'll grant that this is not the same thing. I mean, it's not quite... And also, the Anor Londo archers were way up. Actually, kind of where that knight is now, except even further up. So this isn't quite the same. But yeah, you couldn't go down to the lower area. That always kind of bugged me, especially since by that point they stopped doing the Metroidvania-style shortcuts and started doing more teleport-oriented branching paths. And that was something that annoyed me a bit. I felt like it was a bit of a wasted opportunity because I just felt like you could have gone to the lower areas and had a shortcut from there to Darkroot or to any other area you go into at the start or earlier on. Then you could have had still more shortcut-oriented gameplay, although I realize... It would kind of mess with the City of the Gods idea of Anor Londo, which is that it's cut off, but it's separate from the rest of the world. But it'd be kind of cool. The lower sections of Anor Londo, the areas which presumably were human-occupied, or human-settled, or not human-settled, lived by humans rather than by gods. As you can see, the gods were giants, and therefore you have the giant steps and the small steps, because both humans and the giant gods lived here. But yeah, so... I guess, you know, the lower areas would kind of make sense that they might trend down a bit, and you could then... What the heck? Oh, that's a dark spirit. You could go down a bit, and then from there, there might be a path that people have kind of found or made through to Darkroot Garden, which would make most sense geographically, or possibly... I don't know where, but yeah, basically something where you can go from the top down, but you can't easily find it from the forest. That's another Red-Eye Knight. Okay. Great care should be exercised here. I'm actually curious what's through that door. In the original game, you couldn't get through there normally, so I don't even know if I can here. It might be one of those doesn't open from this side. And locked by some contraption. Same idea. So I'm going to have to get in. I guess deal with this guy. And yeah, as I mentioned before, I've kind of gotten used to, wow. I've kind of gotten used to the Dark Souls 1 references. Wow, for Red Eye Knight, I'm not intimidated in the slightest. But yeah, I've come to peace with the Dark Souls 1 references, which was good timing because we have an entire area from Dark Souls 1. And admittedly, it was relatively pretty area in the original. No hidden path ahead. Well, you're not wrong. Apparently. Nope, you're all right. That's true. Anyhow, yeah, so this is going to lead up to where the Anor Londo archers were, though we encountered the Anor Londo's archers section of Dark Souls 3 already. Though maybe there are more archers. Oh. Oh. Oh, do I have to go back down there? I mean, it's not a big deal. They're still dead, I think. Should still be dead. Because you had to take a back route, and then you had to go through all the house areas, or the rooms of the Anor Londo castle. And then ultimately you'd end up back at that door. And that would lead to the Ornstein and Smough boss fight, which I was talking about a while ago when I pointed out picking up the Leo ring and Ornstein's hammer, or sorry, and Smough's hammer, not Ornstein. Ornstein used a spear. Smough's hammer that referenced the Ornstein and Smough boss fight. No, the giant blacksmith! He's been dead forever. I must write something in mourning. I don't even know what I want to put here. But like, the giant blacksmith's just been lying dead here forever. Who knows how long this place has been the way it is, and they've just left the, oh, well, why am I slashing them? They just left this guy here. That's gonna make me feel really weird if I play Dark Souls 1 again and just see this guy. I mean, he's alive there in this area, like the same general area. There was a shortcut here. You go here, a bunch of gargoyles attack you. The geometry is not exactly the same, but a bunch of gargoyles attack you. And then there's a shortcut gate leading to here where there's actually a bunch of giant knights that are attacking you. We'll probably encounter some like that. The way this area is going, we'll probably encounter those. But the shortcut leads you to the giant blacksmith who's able to upgrade your weapons to level, or to plus 10, I think. Yeah, sorry, upgrade them plus 10. The giant blacksmith is needed to ascend them, because the way it works in Dark Souls 1 is that you got 1 to 4 for normal weapons, and then to get to 5, or sorry, was it 1 to 4 or 1 to 5? I think it was 1 to 5 normally, with Titanite shards, and then you had to use a large Titanite shard, but as an ascension process with Andre, that was not here, that was a different area completely. Also not where he is now, he's not in Firelink Shrine in 1. And then you had large Titanite shards up until, I think, plus 10, and then to get to plus 11, you needed a Titanite chunk and to go to the giant blacksmith, and he ascended those, but he also did boss weapons. So basically this guy does the same thing that transposition guy did, or does now in Firelink Shrine, except the way it worked in 1 was that you actually had to have a base weapon that was upgraded to plus 10 first. So if you wanted one that was a straight sword, you needed to have some kind of straight sword at plus 10, and the necessary soul, and then the giant blacksmith would mash them together and you get a special weapon. In 2 and 3, they made it a lot simpler. You just trade the soul for the weapon. But in 1, it was really complicated. Actually, that guy also did lightning, and you didn't need a gem for it. You just needed to have Titanite shards for lightning. And I think also crystal upgrades, which were also just standard Titanite shards. But yeah, that giant blacksmith, I missed that guy. Now we're in the Great Hall area, which is a lot darker than I remember. And this would be, let me out of here, yeah. They're saying that because in the original, one of these windows is broken, and you could walk down, and actually that's how you got the Dragon Slayer bow in one, was you walk down that area, and that would get you there. And then there's no Silver Knights in here. This is weird. Ah, but I'm not alone. There should be a door here, though. Oh, but it's blocked off. There should be, and there is, and you can't use it. Ah. Well, I know what to do. These are not quite as bad as the Silver Knight Archers in the original. The Silver Knight Archers in Dark Souls 1 were a pain in the butt. There were a bunch of them along the staircases. No, the area I just went through, it was kind of like that, except much narrower. And here. Like, it was kind of like that, except in this room, rather than the outside area we were in before. But it also wasn't fireballs. Ah. Ow. Ow. The Archdeacon forced me. Alright, good. Got rid of them. Phew. Proof of a Concord kept. Another Covenant item. Which Covenant are you a part of? Also, that reminds me. Story time while we're at a bit of peace. Human dregs first. Oh, we already had Proof of a Concord kept, so I won't bother with that. Which one was that again? Oh, Blue Sentinel. Okay, right ear. Human dregs. Proof of a duty fulfilled by the Aldrich faithful who patiently await the devourer of God's return. Dregs are the heaviest thing within the human body, and will sink to the lowest depths imaginable, where they become the shackles that bind this world. So is Aldrich trying to remove all the dregs of the world to unbind people? In a rather Buddhist way? Except extremely forcefully, which is not a very Buddhist way at all. Or are they trying to use all the dregs to trap everyone in the world because they're going to slay the gods and then everyone will... I mean, in theory, be less trapped. The gods were always kind of trapping everybody and just being generally jerks. And slimes. I feel kind of sad seeing all this in ruin. I genuinely do. I really like this area. This is actually one of my favorite areas in Dark Souls 1. Not the Anorlondo Arches area immediately preceding it, but this hall was... I don't know, aesthetically it was really cool, I liked it, now it's in ruins. Which I guess is fitting. I feel like I need to mourn. And it's gonna make it feel really weird if I participate in the reset day events at some point. Because I imagine it'll be going on for weeks, like it'll be effectively reset day state for weeks, so it's not gonna be a big deal if I don't do it immediately. But I feel like I'm gonna feel really weird. Like I'm gonna go and play it again and then be fighting the giant... Admittedly, I guess they were kind of illusory, but the giant knights, the giant gold sentinels, or fighting the... What were they? I guess when you kill Guinevere, it's different, but, you know, it's... The enemies that were here at the start. Oops. That's more the thing you're going to remember. Because you don't necessarily... Darken Anorlondo. Hey, there we go, got my heal back. Ow. Okay, so I guess the real question is, after I open this door and open the shortcut and am able to run back, Ornstein and Smough or Aldrich? I mean, Ornstein and Smough is probably no, because we already got their weapon and ring, and clearly that seems like a pretty clear indication that they're not. Also, I don't know if you just noticed there, but I popped to the other side of the lever when I was on the wrong side. That's really what the hell is that thing? Convenient. But I reiterate my point. What the heck? At least I can see now. Also, thanks for getting rid of the slime for me. Wait, what the? Oh, I'm trapped against the wall. Alright, let's get you outside and then deal with you. Oh crap, curse. Well, I mean, unlike... Shoot. Thankfully, bonfire's down there, so not a big deal. But yeah, a curse doesn't really mean much to me. Like, I mean, okay, yeah, it's instant death, but in Dark Souls 1, that was the only way your health total was reduced. It's not like 2 and 3 where, and Demon Souls, where you have your health total reduced by... Oh, darn, I have to deal with the knights first. Like, in 2 and 3, I had to deal with... What'd you have to do again? Oh, right, yeah. In 2 and 3, you just lose health. Why not locking onto you? Ow. It's nice. I'm gonna lose my souls. I'm not gonna make it through this. I can't seem to get into a useful position to heal, to stabilize. Okay, never mind. I might be okay. I might be fine. Ow. Nope. I'm trying way too hard to poison them out. Which I can do occasionally, but not as often as I need to really make that strategy work. Aye. Well, I got my souls back, at least. Guess we can find out what the boss is. I mean, the spider thing obviously has my curiosity piqued, but... Independent of that. Of course, I'm also vaguely curious where the heck that spider comes from. Ow. Get me out of this area. Okay, come down here so I don't have to deal with the knights next time I have to pick up my souls. Also so I can get a few pot shots off on you. I'm sure the air was greatly threatened by your presence there, spider. I guess I didn't really test it being on this area. It seems to not know what to do here. Okay, now we're in a flat spot. It's back to being useful. I don't remember. I had a chance. I was about to say, use big weapons on big creatures, but no, that was actually a really bad idea. That would have been... I would have killed it if I hadn't done that. Aldrich's stuff is weird. Like, really weird. So... Well, it's like the spider thing. Looks like a weird monkey as a spider. Strange. Anyway, back to my frostbite sword. I thought I was hitting the button. Oh, seriously? I didn't... That was weird. Thought I backstabbed. Oh, well. Hey, I think I have enough large titanite shards to upgrade my claymore again. For whatever good that'll do. I really do like the Wolf Knight Greatswords, but I don't really have a whole lot of motivation to upgrade the claymore. I just feel like I probably should. Anyhow. So the spider's up there somewhere. I just don't know where it is. There it is. Ah. You know, fire is affected by gravity. At least I thought it was. Wait, are you not coming after me? Come on, spider. I'll have you. Wherever you are. And then you might kill me, but we'll see. Oh yeah, I wanted to know how well Lightning Spear does against you. Not very. I'm honestly starting to wonder what the point of Lightning Spear is. Maybe if you're getting great Lightning Spear, it'll make more sense. Oh crap, I'm dead again. Oh, what? I don't know how to make these hitboxes. These staircases make this monster really weird. Ah, shoot. I really should Ember up. I don't know, I don't really want to anymore. Oh, would you die already? Thank you. Aldrich's Ruby. Hey, another Aldrich ring. Malformed ring left by Aldrich, Saint of the Deep. Recovers HP from critical attacks. Aldrich, infamous for his appetite for flesh, apparently had the desire to share with others his joy of imbibing the final shudders of life while luxuriating in his victim's screams. Okay. Anyway, level up time, so I will once again cut back. Alright, well, let's hope that spider doesn't come back. But one thing I'm curious about now, because I've been running the Sapphire since I figure FP is more efficient than HP when it comes to regaining health. But I'm almost starting to wonder if, you know, you mix Pontiff's Left Eye, Ring of the Evil Eye, and Aldrich's Ruby together, if you could actually have a playstyle built around just dealing loads of damage. With how much I've been casting spells, I almost feel like it's worth it, at least for now, to at least switch to Aldrich's Ruby rather than Sapphire. I'm not going to switch up Havel's, though. I mean, if I lose Havel's and I lose a bunch of armor, which I suppose I could, but I don't know. And, yeah, I'm going to keep Lorenti, and of course I'm Vayne. I guess maybe New Game Plus I could try it. Like, just get rid of my Hollowing for New Game Plus, and then, like, once it's done being useful, when new game is done, you can go to new game plus and then deal with that. That's my idea. That's what I'm thinking. Is that I might try the hyper aggressive playstyle there, once my hollowing has been completely, well, dark signs completely dealt with. Okay. Die, will you? Thank you. Oh, I could have tested out the Aldrich Ruby. Get back here. So many. Oh, you know what? I should read those. Helm of the Silver Knights, allegiance to the royals of old. It is said that even after the family's passing, the knights continue to watch over their manor and the ruined cathedral. Okay, cool. So now, one crack at the boss, and then I think we'll call that an episode. Although, I'm curious if the spider's going to come back. Looks like no. Looks like the spider was one shot, which kind of makes sense. It did drop an item. Soup ahead. Oh! Soup ahead. Ow. Well, I mean, this pillar didn't provide much protection in the Ornstein and Smoke fight, so. Oh, wait a sec. I see what this is. So, obviously, there's kind of the pillar thing in Ornstein and Smo, but these attacks, while not exactly the same as, are basically powered up versions of, remember I was talking about Dark Sun Gwendolyn. These are powered up versions of Gwendolyn's attacks. Now, the real question is Aldrich going to be doing different things when I'm close up? Or is it going to teleport away? Oh yeah, teleport away. So this is essentially Darkson Gwendolyn. Powered up. I wonder if that's actually what the story is behind Aldrich. Like that he's basically... Because I mean, even the music... This is Darkson Gwendolyn's music. This is the same music. These are powered up versions of those attacks. Aldrich is basically Gwendolyn. Or at least stage one is basically Gwendolyn. I'm assuming there's multiple stages. This is a Lord of Cinder after all. I can't imagine it'll be that easy. Ah, here we go, stage two. Fire it up. Oh, wow. That looks like Gwendolyn. That actually does kind of look like Gwendolyn. Or at least it sort of has that feminine look to it. All right, cool. So, found another Lord of Cinder. That was quick. Anyway, as promised, that's going to be it. So, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.